Good morning, students.
Today is our science class for 8th standard. Lesson number 1, crop production and management. In our previous class, we learned about a different steps on agricultural practice. We are learning about the different steps of agricultural practice. And the first step is preparation of soil. After preparing a soil, we need to select and sowing of seeds. And the next step, after selecting and sowing of seeds, we need to add a manure and fertilizer for the soil. And the next fourth important step in agricultural practice is irrigation. In today's class, we are going to learn about irrigation. Water is essential and important for proper growth and development of the crops. We get water from two sources, naturally by the rainfall and in artificial method of irrigation.
Water is essential for the proper cultivation of a crop. Water is essential for proper cultivation of a crop. It was done naturally by the rainfall and by the artificial method. The artificial supply of water to agricultural field is called irrigation. Absence of moisture in the soil leads to frost and hot air current.
Irrigation. The supply of water to crops at regular intervals are called irrigation. The supply of water to crops at regular interval. Here interval means time. At regular time is called irrigation. Now let's see what are the sources of irrigation. The main source of water for irrigations are
well, dams, ponds, lakes, rivers and canals.
The sources of water for irrigations are wells, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers, dams and canals. There are two different methods of irrigation. One is traditional method and modern method. Traditional method is classified into four types: moat or pulley system, chain pump system, decklay system and rahat system. Come, let's see one by one.
Two different methods of irrigation. One is traditional and another one is modern. In traditional method, moat or pulley, chain pump system, decklay system and rahat system. Modern system of irrigation is classified into two types. One is sprinkler system and other one is drip system. In first method, comes under traditional method. And the first one is moat or pulley system. Here the water is carried by the bucket and it was lifted on a channel. With the help of channels, it was passed through the crops. The bucket is connected to the pulley and at the another end it was connected to a buffalo. If an animal moves, the water is carried from the bucket. The system is chain pump system. Here it was connected to the two wheels. One wheel at a top and another wheel at a bottom. The water is carried from the well or a canal with the help of a bucket. And it was lifted to upwards with the help of shift and the handle. The water is then poured to the channels. And with the help of channels, it was passed to the crop. Next system is the decalay system. Here, the source of water is carried with the help of log and the fork-shaped wood. Let's see how the process is done by the farmers. The water is carried by the bucket and it was poured into a channel. With the help of channels, the water is carried out through the field.
Rahat system involves two wheels, one placed vertically over a water source and other in horizontally placed over a distance. The belt of bucket is placed on the first wheel. The belt of bucket is placed on the first wheel. On the other side, animals like ox, buffalo or camel are tied to other wheels. When an animal moves over the wheel around in a circular motion, the first wheel with a bucket draw water from the source. The first wheel with the bucket draws water from the source which irrigate the field.
Next, in today's class, we learned about irrigation.